Good morning. Thank you guys for being here this morning. My name is Captain Christopher Bergner from the Los Angeles County Sheriff's Homicide Bureau, and I'm joined here today by Commander Steve Katz, Investigators Adan Torres, Gus Carrillo, Captain Berg from San Dimas Sheriff Station, from the 1st District Board of Supervisors, Supervisor Solis, and Guadalupe Villa, who tragically lost her daughter during this incident. On Saturday, January 6, 2018, just before 10 p.m., 15-year-old Karla Villa, who was a sophomore at Baldwin Park High School, was hanging out with her friends. Karla and other kids stood on a residential sidewalk in the 4500 block of Heathdale Avenue in the unincorporated area of Covina. This area is known as the Charter Oak community, as they waited for a social media event to begin. As the teens monitored their cell phones and vehicles passed, one vehicle slowed during them and chaos erupted when shots were fired. Karla was struck in the head and fatally wounded in front of her friends. Karla was transported to a local hospital where she was pronounced dead the next afternoon. The Board of Supervisors, in support of the Sheriff's Department, has posted a $20,000 reward for information used to solve this case. It's our hope that as you learn the details of this incident, it clears up some of the misinformation that's been put out there and helps spread some information so we can find some closure in this tragic event. I'd like to introduce Investigator Adan Torres, who will provide you some details regarding this crime.
Good morning, thank you for coming. You guys have been a great help in helping us with our cases in the past. Hopefully we'll have the same success this time. That night on Saturday, the 6th of January, Karla was waiting for a party, like my captain said, with a group of about 20 other teenagers, close proximity to her age. On that street, from what we've learned, there was different groups near her, probably 50 yards away from her, up to 100 yards away from her, up and down the block, waiting for the same party. What we're asking is that if anybody saw anything or knows anything, please come forward and help us with this. Karla was truly an innocent victim. She was just waiting for a party like any normal teenager, and that night suffered the gunshot wound that subsequently caused her death. Initially, we disseminated information that the black SUV that was initially reported as driving by and shooting, that's what we initially thought. Through our investigation, me and Detective Carrillo have discovered that we don't believe that that's necessarily so. We believe that whoever did shoot shot from the group that was nearby or standing with Karla, close to her. So that's what we're asking. We know that there was approximately anywhere from 10 to 12 teenagers close to her in that group, and if any of those teenagers know anything, we're asking to please come forward and help us with this investigation. Any questions from you guys?
Just to clarify, so no longer a drive-by, maybe a drive-by, but maybe they were standing, so it's just unsure?
So we're unsure about the drive-by. We don't have any solid information that black SUV actually fired. It could be, if witnesses come forward and tell us different, you know, it could be, but from what we've learned, it's definitely somebody on the street, somebody on foot.
Was there something that was found there at the scene which indicates somebody on foot fired? Did you find cartridge casings? Anything else there?
We did find cartridge casings and other facts that are leading us to believe that.
Otherwise, if he was inside a car, you wouldn't have the rounds going out?
Not necessarily so. You could stick your hand out, you know, so. Sir, you were going to follow something up?
The fact that there being so many kids on the street, if you could talk to somebody saw something, if you could speak to those kids right now who are watching, if you could speak to them to speak up.
Imagine that this is one of your brothers or one of your sisters, and would you want the other kids to come forward and help us? I definitely would.
Was there an actual
The house was not abandoned, it was under construction, and the party was scheduled to begin. It was one of those impromptu social media flyer parties.
Was the party supposed to be in the house that was under construction, or was it supposed to be in an actual
The address was next door. The address where the party was supposed to be held was next door.
The way that it was presented before, completely random, was she targeted? Can you speak to the fact of her standing there on her cell phone, seemingly innocent, and if she was a random victim?
You explained exactly how it happened. She was standing there on her cell phone and completely random, just a complete innocent victim. She was just, you know, happened to be in the way of the shots that were fired. I don't know, sir. I wouldn't be able to answer that. You know, it was just a group of kids that was in the way, you know, like any of the other four or five different groups that were in or near the street. She was just one of those kids, wanted to go to a party that night, and this happened to her.
Your message to the actual suspect that that person's watching.
Once again, you know, imagine that this happened to one of your family members. And there's two sides to every story. If you know, we need to get all the sides, so Karla's voice could be heard. You know, she didn't deserve this. I'm going to introduce that one last one. No, some knew each other, but I mean, there were different groups. Like I said, there were several groups of kids up and down that street. So I'm going to introduce Supervisor Solis now, who's going to speak to you guys.
Fortunately, this isn't the only time when the county board steps in and puts forward a motion, which I did, to help put up a $20,000 reward after talking to the investigators that this was something that was warranted. It's really a tragic moment to think about a young girl at the age of 15 who just happened to be perhaps at the wrong place at the wrong time, and her life was taken. I do hope that this will help to serve those people that were there, any witnesses to come forward, and if people have in their hearts to understand how tragic it is to lose a young one, a sophomore, a young girl who had her life dreams, wanting to become a nurse to help others, and to have dreams of traveling and having a good life, and then all of a sudden her life is taken away. We hope that the community in the surrounding area will come forward, and that people will speak up and come forward and give as much information as they can. It's tragic, and we need to make sure that we do everything we can to know where our young children are going, what's happening, but also to be mindful that a young woman's life has been taken, and there's a lot of sorrow in the family and in our community. So I hope people will understand there is an urgency for people to come forward. Thank you. And I want to thank our Los Angeles Sheriff's investigators for the work that they do, and we hope that we can find some closure to this. Thank you.
Next, we're going to have Karla's mother, Guadalupe, and Detective Torres will be helping interpret for those non-Spanish speakers.
Pues quiero darle las gracias por que están aquí y no es fácil para mí estar aquí. Pues quiero suplicarle a alguien o alguien si sabe algo o si alguien miró algo. Que hable, que esto no se quede así. Es duro todo esto que está pasando. No es fácil. Te pido a la gente, por favor, si sabe algo, que hable, por favor.
Please. Guadalupe would like to thank all of you for being here and helping with this. It's not easy for her to be here, and she's pleading to the public or anyone that has any information to please come forward and help this. She says it's not easy for her to stand here, and it's very hard with what she's going through, and is asking for help from the public to help us.
¿Que por qué hizo esto? Quiero saber por qué hizo esto. ¿Por qué me quitó a mi hija? Yo pienso que no la conocía para hacerle esto. Pues, no. Nomás quiero que pues que piense él lo que hizo, que me hizo mucho daño. Y es, me quitó a mi hija. Y es algo que siempre voy a cargar con esto. Yo pienso que yo no lo conozco a que me hubiese hecho esto. Me hizo mucho daño a mí y a mis hijas, a mi familia, a todos. Nos causó un algo. Pues solamente él sabe por qué lo hizo. Es todo.
She'd like to say to whoever did this, she wants to know why he did this. She doesn't think that he knew her daughter, and she doesn't believe that she knows him, and wants to know why he caused so much damage to her, her other daughters, her family, and really caused a lot of damage to her. ¿Quiere saber la significancia del monito que está deteniendo usted?
Este era, se lo regalaron y él con él, andaba ya siempre con él, siempre dormía con él.
It was a gift that was given to Karla, and it was the doll that she always slept with, and she would always be hugging it.
Any other questions? If not, I implore you guys to please focus on the photo and get that out to the general public. This is a 15-year-old girl that never had an opportunity to live the rest of her life. And if it was any one of our children, we'd implore everybody to step forward and please produce information, bring forward some information so that we can bring some closure to the family and some justice to Karla. Every one of us who have kids know exactly what it would be like and don't ever want to be in that position. So I thank you guys again for coming and appreciate the help.